The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Christmas, a season of love, joy, peace and harmony. When we look around, we could see the world is full of anxieties, uncertainties, disharmony due to this period of pandemic maybe. But we do expect a savior to re-establish the discrepancies which happened here. The imbalance caused due to various reasons. The Savior brings joy and peace to reunite the broken relationship from the people. Once upon a time, there was a town where the people were struggling hard and suffering very much due to the lack of rain for years. They came to know a monk is little bit far away, living an austere life, who could be able to bring rain to their place. They approached him. He reached there, traveling from far away. He could sense the realities, something discomfort is happening. So he asked them, "Give me 3 days' time. I don't want to be related with anybody. I'll stay alone. No food, no convenience, nothing needed." And he went away. After 3 days, they could see miraculously the heavy downpour. They approached the monk and inquired how it happened. He narrated, as he reached there, he could sense the disharmony of the place, of the people, the imbalance of the nature. The discrepancies happened there, and the lack of coordination, collaboration, and relationship among the people, their connection with the God, everything is in danger. So he emptied himself without food, leading an austere life for these 3 days, intensely praying to God, and he brought God's blessing down. Nothing he has done, only his life, his emptiness, his kenosis showered the graces on the people. Yes, my dear friends, the Savior coming to this world to mend the brokenness, to reunite the relationship which is broken, to remove the discrepancies and the disharmony, to re-establish a harmonious relationship of the people toward God, towards nature. That is what is lacking in that place, blocking the showers of blessings from God. When we analyze and evaluate our present condition, we could sense the same, the lack of relationship among the people to God, to the nature, to the person himself or herself. Jesus the Savior coming down to the earth to make each one of us to experience the celestial bliss, the showers of graces and blessings from the Almighty. Because God has given His only begotten Son to the world out of His infinite love, only to save us from the clutches of evil powers. That's what is needed. So during this Christmas, we hopefully expect the Savior to re-establish the brokenness from this world. Each one consciously should strive hard to relate with God, to relate with nature, to relate with one another, and to make ourselves more purified and sanctified. That is the real spirit of Christmas. We all expect that harmonious relationship in this world, among the people. Then they could experience the peace which he had promised to the humanity. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. The salutation of the angels could be experienced only by our emptying of the pleasures of the world and relating and connecting with the Heavenly Father, with the celestial bodies. Then only we could really experience Christmas. During this Christmas day, let us hopefully promise each one will try hard to re-establish what all things are broken from us. For that, let the infant Jesus bless each one of us to have a reunion with each one, with the people who come in contact with us, with God, with the nature. Yes, with this real invocation to the Lord, wish you a prosperous and merry Christmas. Yes, a merry, prosperous, blissful, graceful Christmas greetings to one and all. Thank you.